Hi there, I'm immigration attorney Heather Poole. Are you worried about traveling abroad for your consulate interview and getting stuck in administrative processing or being refused a visa even though you have a waiver approval? Then this video is for you. If you have received an approval for a provisional I-601A waiver, then your immigration history, according to what CIS knows, is that you have been in the U.S. for 1 year or more without valid status and plan to depart the United States for your consular interview abroad, and will then trigger the 10-year bar of unlawful entry under the Immigration and Nationality Act. The provisional waiver allowed you to waive the unlawful presence bar instead of having to apply for it after your consulate interview abroad, significantly cutting down on the time spent separated from your spouse or loved ones in the United States. But just because USCIS approved your waiver, however, does not mean that the consulate will issue your immigrant visa and allow you to return to the U.S. The consulates have been revoking approved provisional waivers and making immigrants file traditional I-601 waivers after the consulate interview based on new grounds of inadmissibility that come out at the interview. The I-601A only waives unlawful presence. If the consulate believes that you committed fraud or misrepresentation when you last entered the U.S. because, for instance, you overstayed your B2 visitor visa and started working right away on your F1 student visa, never had the intent to go to school, then a provisional waiver that only waives your years of unlawful presence will be considered invalid because you also have to file the misrepresentation waiver. Recently, since the Department of State put new guidance out about a 90-day presumption of fraud rule, i.e. getting married, working illegally, applying for adjustment of status or other actions within the first 90 days of a non-immigrant visa entry, that look like you lied about your true intent when applying in the past for a temporary non-immigrant visa at the consulate, more and more provisional waivers are in danger of being revoked. Previously, the Department of State would follow guidance that presumed fraud or misrepresentation in any of these actions occurred within 30 days of entry, followed by a rebuttable presumption of fraud within the first 30 to 90 days, and no presumption of fraud if this all occurred after 90 days of entry. Even C1 crewmen entrants are running into this presumption of fraud now at interviews, and the provisional waivers are being revoked if they did not join the cruise ship they were supposed to, even if abandoned by their contact or had no way to connect with the ship or left the ship earlier or did not fulfill their contract. The applicant is forced to file a traditional 601 waiver requesting a waiver for both unlawful presence and misrepresentation. But consulates can also find a ground of inadmissibility that you can't overcome and not allow you to refile the traditional 601 waiver after the consulate revokes your provisional 601A. Many times, immigrants and their attorneys focus on the last entry into the U.S. and start counting unlawful presence for purposes of the 10-year bar from that date only. They ignore the potential that you could have triggered the permanent bar on prior entries. The permanent bar has no waiver available, so besides getting your hopes up that the provisional waiver is the hardest part of the case to overcome and the consulate interview should be a breeze, the reality is that many immigrants are barred for 10 years from coming back to the U.S. due to the permanent bar, and the provisional waiver does them no good. So if you have triggered the permanent bar, the consulate will deny your immigrant visa and you will be stuck abroad for 10 years with no possibility of a waiver. If an immigrant was previously unlawfully present for more than a year, that attempted to re-enter the U.S. illegally, whether or not they were successful in this attempt, the immigrant has triggered the permanent bar. And unlike the 10-year bar for unlawful presence that does have a waiver, there is no waiver for the permanent bar. It's a 10-year period where you are stuck outside the United States. And for the permanent bar, unlike the regular 10-year bar, unlawful presence even counts under the age of 18. So be super careful when starting the provisional waiver process to ensure you won't run into the permanent bar and be stuck abroad. Some 601As are being revoked to add the additional inadmissibility ground of smuggling as well. When the consulate asks detailed questions about how you specifically came to the U.S. and when you entered, who you were with, what their ages were, and how you were related to you. Could you be pinned with aiding or assisting a younger sibling to come across who was with you? If so, there's no waiver for a sibling. Be careful. So what does this all mean? Go into the consulate interview and even the initial application process for the 601A provisional waiver with open eyes. Look at your immigration history from a skeptic's eye. What facts could make it appear that you lied to the consulate or to CBP during your last entry that could undermine your credibility at your upcoming consulate interview? Are there any emails, declarations, or documentation you can provide to back up your story regarding a change of events since you last entered the U.S., or other documentation supporting your position if you came in on a work visa to deter the consulate from concluding that you committed fraud? What else can you or your attorney provide or have ready for the consular officer if this issue comes up? Or another issue such as a crime that there is risk that the consulate determines makes you inadmissible as a crime of moral turpitude, for instance. And make sure you choose an attorney who will prepare you for the interview itself, which can be quite short but very stressful, and a lot could go wrong. The more prepared you are with documentation and knowledge of the issues that this area is likely to come up in your case, the more likely you will pass the interview. Try to flesh out all potential issues in your case before you interview. And prepare for the potential that you will not be able to return right away if your case is revoked. If your family depends on you financially to keep your U.S. job, you better prepare for this potential disaster with savings or help from others in place in case you can't return soon. If revoked, you have to reapply for a traditional unlawful presence waiver, and the new ground of inadmissibility, whether it's a crime, smuggling, misrepresentation, or another ground. It's best to flesh out potential worst-case scenario with your attorney before you even start the 601A provisional waiver process, so you and your family can plan and you know exactly what you're getting into. I wish you the best of luck in your immigration case and reuniting with your loved one. If you would like our help, visit our website, humanrightsattorney.com, to book your appointment or give us a call today. If you would like to hear more about this subject, please like or comment below and join our channel by subscribing.